Good morning, everybody. My name is Guy, and I'm the founder of MobieTrain. Brick-and-mortar retail is facing a lot of challenges. We see nowadays that there are a lot of store closings, a lot of bad messaging along. But there is hope. We see that 82% of millennials still prefer to shop in store. But this on one major condition. They want to receive a great customer experience day after day in their interactions. And the question is, how can retailers deliver that experience day after day in all of their stores? One word is key to me, and that's knowledge. They need to empower their employees with more knowledge than ever before, and they struggle doing it. And that's where our solution comes in play. Our micro-learning platform is built around three cornerstones. We have a content management system, which allows the retailer to make their own learning tracks in a very easy way. And that can be a learning track of 1 week to introduce a new product, but it can also be a learning track of 1 year around customer service and sales techniques. We have the application, which I demo you in a second. And then we have also a dashboard where the retailer can see how the people are active, how engaged they are, and where are the knowledge gaps in their workforce. So let's take a look at the application. So we log in via an easy screen, and the first thing you will see is a very visual learning path. So you go from one level to another, and you can create as many as you want. You see the big dots being skills, and for each of those skills, we have a few learning moments. So here we have host with three learning moments, and we're going to zoom in on the first impression. A little text to set the scene. Then we have media to enrich it. Here a video, it can be also a PowerPoint presentation. And then some fun quizzes with gamification that pops into the screen. If you go to the bottom of the application, you have a burger menu where you go to your profile page and you can see the progress into the learning path, the scores that you got, etc. We have badges to hook them even more on the platform. And last but not least, we have a search function where at any given time they can look up a course when they need it. If we look at the market, and I think yesterday that was in some of the keynotes, then we know that learning is booming. But more specifically, mobile learning is growing very, very rapidly. That also means that there is quite a lot of competition, and competition that comes from different angles. You have, on the one hand, onboarding communication platforms. On the other hand, more pure learning systems. If I take the first two, for me, I don't see it really as competition, but rather as an opportunity for partnerships, which is so important in HR tech. If I look more on the learning side, then of course the question poses itself, how are we different? Well, the first element in that aspect is really focus. We focus on retail. We made this with retailers for retailers. Secondly, a knowledge retention algorithm that we built in. The intrinsic motivation that we use in order to power our gamification. And the mobile-first ID, which is really the DNA of our company. And then last but not least, in our founders team, we have a lot of retail experience and a big network in retail. If you mix that all together, well, that's what really makes us unique. And that's what you see in the success we had so far. We launched the platform in March of this year. So far, we have more than 7 clients, 10,000 users, and active in 13 countries, mostly Middle East and Benelux, and you see some of the great references behind. We do this with a scalable business model, where most of our revenue is coming from licenses, also some content guidance, sometimes creation, and integrations. If we look to the financial projections, then we see a nice trajectory for the next coming years, where most of that growth is coming from the retail space, because we want to become a market leader in that space. But then over time, we also see, of course, different industries where we can go. We're currently doing a capital round where we're looking for 1 million. Sales marketing is the most important thing for us right now. But secondly, also our product development is important. We think about social learning, which is something we want to enrich our platform with, and also an AI-powered newsfeed with all the data that we have in our platform. And to end this, of course, I could not do this without a great team, where we have a team with complementary skill sets, with a lot of retail and business experience, prior startup experience, and also tech in the team. I thank you very much, and I'm looking forward to the questions of the
gym. Yeah! Woo! Well done. Questions? Ernst, do you want to start?
Jerome, thanks. Great presentation, Guy. As an investor, we always look at the customer acquisition time versus the lifetime value. So how much time, you have a lot of B2B clients I saw on your list, how much time does it take you to onboard one of those clients, and how much time does it take for you from an investor perspective to recover that in their lifetime value?
Thank you. So in general, we see enterprises, of course, longer lead times. In the beginning, it took us, let's say, 8 months to a year to get the client on board. Nowadays, we see that we have 3 to 6 months to have the client signed, which I think is a pretty short period of time. Once we have them on board, we see that very quickly there is a lot of positive engagement that comes from the stores, where people really say that they like that way of working, that it's something new for them, and definitely for the people that are doing that in the stores. So we see a quick uplift, actually, once they start to use it, and a high engagement in the stores. To say how that exactly translates in the money, that's a little bit too early, because there we need to do a bit more research. And on top of that, in learning, that's always a very difficult question to answer.
Yeah. Bill?
Hi, good show. I was a little bit confused about whether you're an LMS or a publisher, whether you're publishing content.
Yeah, so actually we are partially an LMS, you could say, but with LMS, most of the time, people put the focus on the M of management. And for us, it's actually the focus on the L of learning experience. We want to make sure that everything we do is really centered around that person in the store, that person who's remote, and to give them the right tools, but we also do the management or make it possible for a retailer in a very easy way to make their tracks, if that answers your question.
So where is the content actually coming from?
The content is coming most of the time from the retailer themselves, so they create it, they can upload it into our system, and this way make their own learning paths in a very easy way.
China?
Hi. Great presentation.
Thank you. So
this looks like a millennial product for millennial and younger users, right? Mm-hmm. When I live in the US, and when I go into a retail shop that isn't fashion, most of the workers are not millennials, they're older, right? Mm-hmm. So do you see challenges with adoption in a national pharmacy store where most of the workers are older than 50, older than 60, with adoption in that regard?
I think nowadays, when you look at also elderly people who are a bit
older.
No.
I wasn't saying elderly. I don't think 60 is elderly, please.
What I wanted to say is that actually people are digital savvy and at all ages. So it's more a culture shift which you need to do in a company. And it can be, of course, a little bit easier when you have a millennial workforce than the other workforce. But it's more that shift which comes, I think, from the higher management to say that they want to do it. The big advantage for whatever user it is, whatever age group they have, that it's easy, it's efficient, they don't lose too much time, and it's fun. And most of the time, if you have a different target group, your content should be, of course, adapted to that target group. But the tool to deliver it, people are used to work with their smartphones, with the tablets, and they love it.
All right. Maybe one last question, Jason?
So I'm curious, you're obviously still early, but as we all know in retail, it's a high turnover industry. Are you seeing any trends in terms of employees staying longer because they're using the technology, or would you predict that demographic of worker will stay longer by using your technology?
It is too early to say it with exact figures, but what for me is very clear is that target group that we're going after, there was never a lot invested in. They don't have too much money to invest big trainings for them, and our tool allows that. We make it efficient, we make it possible for them to invest a constant flow of training for those people, and I'm pretty sure that will help in order to empower those people more and to bring more engagement to the work floor.
All right. Thank you very much, Guy. We're going to have the rating now. Are you guys ready? Or yeah? Like, okay, you got your cards? Oh, come on. Judges, right? Okay, so before they judge, we're going to have a massive, massive encouragement for Guy. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Woo! All right. So we're judging on the product first and the pitch second. The product first, the pitch second. Ready for the product? 3, 2, 1, up. All right, 4, 4, 4, 3, 2, 5, 3, 4, 4. That sounds great. Mm-hmm. Cards down. And now we're judging the pitch, which was actually quite good, very structured. All right, 3, 2, 1, pitch up. Oh, 5, 3, 5, 5, 4. 4, 5, 3, 5, 5, yeah. Well done,
thank
man.
You.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.